How can you have a positive influence on others? Stick around to find out. Welcome back, and congratulations on taking one more step towards becoming one of the great leaders of tomorrow. We've heard a lot the last few years about influencers and thought leaders. We may think some of these people are great leaders and aspire to be like them, but we say to ourselves, I don't have that kind of reach, or nobody wants to listen to me talk about something. But being an influencer is as simple as finding topics and ideas that we're passionate about and sharing our thoughts on them with others. Influencing thought in a positive way is one of our key responsibilities as leaders. Sometimes it can be difficult to believe that other people might want to hear what we have to say, or we think we don't know enough about a topic to speak about it. But the truth is, people who care about their professions and organizations are open to new ideas, debate, and discussion about the things that are important to them. There may be some haters out there, but let's not worry about them. Let's focus on finding people who share our values and ideas and connecting with them. If we sit down and think about it, we all probably have one or two areas in our life where we have some valuable expertise or life experience that we can share to help someone else out. If we keep this expertise and experience to ourselves, someone who could really use some advice might not get it. Here are a few tips to help you be an influencer in a positive and productive way. First, figure out what you're good at. This is where you sit down and say, what is the unique expertise and experience I have that no one else has? Then find your audience. Figure out who are the people who could benefit most from the expertise and experience you have to share, or find a group of people who share your passion for this topic and share your ideas with them. It's important that you tell your own story. Use examples and experiences to emphasize the points you're trying to make. People enjoy and remember stories, especially if they're well told, much more than they remember a list of bulletized points. You also have to make sure you pick your moments wisely. When you choose to share what you have to offer is often more important than what you share. An informal discussion in the office can be more effective than trying to wedge a story into an already packed agenda for a staff meeting. Here at Evil Genius Leadership, we talk about getting in the right mindset for various activities a lot, and preparing to be an influencer is no different. If we come to these kinds of conversations with the mindset of helping others be successful by sharing our experience and expertise with them, we usually have a lot better results than if we're trying to be considered an expert or to get our own way. Also, if we come to these discussions with an open mind, it allows others to share their experience and expertise and helps the group grow together. We also might learn a little something as a result. If you found this helpful, don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Facebook. And remember, you can join us every Friday at 10 a.m. for an interactive leadership discussion live on Blab. You can also click off to that globe on the right, and that'll get you subscribed to our email list and bring all of our content direct to your inbox. I want to thank you for watching. I appreciate it as always. And remember, the future is out there. Lead the way.